A Lubbock family asking for your help after a car crashed into their home in the middle of the night and then drove off. KLBK's Brenda Lipinski spoke to the family. Now, Brenda, do we know how much this is going to cost the family to fix?
You know what, Terry? This happened all so suddenly. They're still getting that assessed. It's definitely something they never imagined that would happen to them. And they're hoping that by telling their story that someone will come forward.
When we heard the crash, I got up in a panic.
The sound Mario Zapata heard was just before 5 a.m. on Sunday morning.
The first thing that went through my mind was my mother. She lives here. She just recently fell and broke her hip.
He says the vehicle knocked down a wall.
All the bricks and everything were laying there, just a big gaping hole. It hit at just the right spot, right between the two windows.
Luckily, there was only a laundry room on the other side of the wall.
We have my four-year-old nephew living here, and he could have been injured, he could have been killed. Somebody could have been in the laundry room working, you know, doing something here and could have gotten seriously injured. So I'm definitely grateful that, you know, nobody was on this side of the house at the time.
To make matters worse, Zapata says him and his family have only lived in the house for 6 months.
It definitely angers me that somebody could, because, yeah, like I said, any time a vehicle crashes into something like that, there's a potential for serious harm or even death. And for somebody to be able to just drive away from that without checking to see if anybody was injured or killed, that's kind of mind-blowing.
The worst part, he says, is there's no security camera footage.
It feels like somebody physically harmed or robbed us and just got away with it, left without, you know, we don't even have a face to put blame on.
The Zapata family says they've had positive response from the community. Some neighbors nearby even offering for them to look through their camera footage to see if anything comes up. And they said they'd love to find the person who did it, but they're mostly grateful that no one was injured.